We have seen in previous lectures the importance of sub-diagrams to understand and visualize the redox chemistry of an element in aqueous solution. However, there is another important type of reaction that can be interpreted with the diagram presented, that is the extraction of metal from its oxides. Most of metals are found in nature as oxides or sulfides, and only a few of them occur in nature as their elements. Therefore, an important type of redox reaction is the extraction of metals from their ores by reduction. In order to choose the appropriate reductant and the necessary conditions to achieve the reaction, we employ the Ellingham diagrams. An Ellingham diagram summarizes the dependence of the standard Gibbs energy of formation of metal oxides with temperature. Normally, the oxygen partial pressure is taken as 1 atmosphere, and all reactions are normalized to consume 1 mole of oxygen gas. These diagrams will help us to predict the feasibility of reduction of an oxide ore. Considering as a reasonable approximation that the standard change in enthalpy and entropy are independent with temperature, in general terms, an increase of the temperature produces a more negative Gibbs energy value for most of the metal oxides. The representation of the free energy versus temperature can be drawn as a series of straight lines where the variation of entropy with opposite sign will be the slope of the line and the variation of enthalpy the y-intercept according to the following well-known relationship. The majority of lines represented in the Ellingham diagram slopes upwards. That means they have opposite slopes because the variation of standard entropy in the formation reaction of an oxide is negative. This fact can be easily deduced because this reaction implies a reduction in the number of moles of gaseous substances, which implies a reduction of the entropy due to the fact that the standard molar entropy of gases are much longer than those of solids. This relationship of the slope with the entropy explains the changes in the slope for the same reaction when the temperature is increasing. Obviously, if there is a change in the state of the metal because it melts or vaporizes, the slope will change due to the fact that the entropy of each state is also different. Let's examine the formation of a particular oxide, such as thin oxide, which is easily obtained at room temperature, according to the following reaction. The change in entropy for this oxidation reaction is negative, as we have explained before, and therefore it would be the variation of enthalpy the driving force in the reaction. The negative value of the enthalpy for the oxidation of thin favors the reaction of oxidation. The increase of the temperature will gradually make the value of Gibbs energy less negative, and eventually it will reach the value of zero. The temperature at which the line intercepts with the horizontal line of variation of Gibbs energy equals zero represents the equilibrium of the three species under 1 atmosphere in partial pressure of oxygen. At higher temperatures, the formation of the oxide won't be spontaneous anymore, and it will be the reduction of the oxide to give the element the favored process. However, this is not a convenient method to obtain the pure metal because it wouldn't be practical, since it would require very high temperatures, and in addition, it would be necessary to separate the pure metal from the oxygen before cooling down in order to avoid further recombination to form the oxide again. Obviously, there is a more convenient way to obtain the pure metal, and that consists on reducing the oxide with an element which forms a more stable oxide than the one is reduced. That is the case for carbon, which is usually not only fulfill these requirements, but also is a very cheap reactant. In order to achieve successfully the reduction of a metal oxide with carbon, or even when carbon monoxide, one of the following reactions needs to have a more negative Gibbs energy than the corresponding reaction of the formation of the metal oxide. The variation of Gibbs energy with the temperature for these three reactions is a relevant aspect to consider in order to understand the process of reduction of a metal oxide with carbon or carbon monoxide. In the case of deoxidation of carbon to carbon monoxide, the line slopes downwards because 2 moles of carbon monoxide are produced for each 1 mole of oxygen gas used. That means that the entropy change will be positive and the slope negative. The standard reaction entropy for the oxidation of carbon to carbon dioxide is close to zero, as there is no net change in the amount of gas, so we have an horizontal line. For the oxidation of carbon monoxide to carbon dioxide, we have a negative change in the standard reaction entropy due to the number of gas moles is reduced from 3 in the reagents to 2 moles in the product. According to this explanation, and considering that the oxidation of carbon to carbon monoxide is downward sloping, this line will eventually cross the upward sloping line for the conversion of the metal in its oxide. This makes carbon usually useful as a reducing agent. As soon as the line of oxidation of carbon lies below a methyl oxidation line, the reaction is thermodynamically possible. For example, thin is manufactured by carbon reduction at temperatures greater than 1200 Kelvin. Similar remarks apply to the other two oxidation lines of carbon. So, for temperatures at which the CO2 line goes below the methyl oxide line, then carbon can be employed to achieve this reduction, but it is oxidized to carbon dioxide. Analogously, for temperatures at which CO2 lines lies below the methyl oxide line, carbon monoxide can reduce the methyl and be oxidized to carbon dioxide. The three lines intersect at 710 Celsius, so carbon monoxide is a better reducing agent below this temperature, and carbon is a better reducing agent above this temperature. For some metals, the temperature required to reduce the oxide with carbon is so much high that the process is not profitable. And for some electropositive elements with very negative Gibbs energy, this reduction is not favorable thermodynamically. However, any metal can be used as a reductant agent as long as the Gibbs energy of the formation of each oxide is more negative than the Gibbs energy of the oxide of the element to be reduced. That can be easily illustrated in the Ellingham diagram, so that any metal will reduce the oxide of other metal which its line of formation is above in the Ellingham diagram.